while markets yield very good outcomes for the most part for a great majority of society, sometimes markets don't do what we want them to. Sometimes they fail. There are different kinds of market failures, but one of the more common ones is referred to as an externality. An externality is created when two parties involved in a trade or involved in some sort of market activity generate either costs or benefits to some outside third party. Now that sounds a little confusing, so let's take a look at a couple of examples. The most common example of an externality is pollution. A factory is producing things to sell, and so there'll be some benefit that's created by the exchange of those goods between the factory owner and the buyer. But in the process of making these things, there might be some air pollution, water pollution, light pollution, some other kind of pollution that's generated that some other group of people has to pay for. So if you're living along a riverbank and a company is dumping toxins into the river, they don't pay the full price of production. They don't pay for the cost of the externality, the cost of the pollution. You do by living downstream and not being able to use the river, not being able to wash your clothes if there's air pollution, and hang them out to dry because the air pollution makes them dirty, or you get cancer as a result of some type of pollution. That kind of externality is called a negative externality. For obvious reasons, there are costs imposed upon people who have no role in creating them. From society's perspective, we have a divergence of interests. Here we see in a graph the normal demand and supply. Supply represents the marginal cost of production, where demand represents the marginal benefit of production. In the case of a negative externality, there is another cost curve to take into consideration, society's cost curve. Society's cost curve, or the supply society would like to see, lies to the northwest of the market supply curve. And so what we see is this: the intersection of the private supply curve, the supply curve that's observed by the producer, the intersection of that curve and the demand curve would yield us this level of output, the output that's in the interest of the private firm. From society's perspective, there are other costs that should be taken into consideration. And if the producer did take those into consideration, the supply curve would shift up to the left and less would be produced. We would find the intersection of that society supply curve and the demand curve, and we would see that the quantity from society's perspective would be lower. And incidentally, it would be lower and sold at a higher price. The negative externality is found by the distance at any output between the two supply curves. That's the amount of the externality, or the dollar value of the externality. Now, there could be positive externalities. This occurs when somebody does something really great and other people benefit from it. Now, the problem for the producer of the externality is that they don't get compensated for their work. In this example, in this graph, what we see is that there's a cost curve, a supply curve, and there's a benefit curve or a demand curve. And if this is the private exchange, then our quantity from the private exchange is shown here. However, if the true societal demand was illustrated, we would see that the demand curve should actually be further out to the right. People really want this product. They want more of the product because they're receiving a benefit from it. And so the true societal output for a good that generates a positive externality would be further to the right, and incidentally at a higher price. An example of a good that produces a positive externality would be something like education. Even though you may not be involved in producing the education of a public school, you may be retired, you may be in the workforce, and you're not engaged in the public school system, there are benefits to society from having an educated workforce, an educated population, people who know how to read and write and who can understand the civics of a country. And so there's a positive externality created by having more people educated. The problem is, if it was left to the private sector, there wouldn't be enough people educated, and so government would step in and subsidize education to fix this perceived market failure. To fix the pollution problem, of course, government might step in and tax the firm that's producing the pollution in order to get their costs to rise and hopefully to get the firm to produce less of that product.